the everlasting God. You do not think you won't grow weary. You're the defender of the weak. You comfort those in need. You lift us up on wings like
stand here and see people who have a passion, a hunger for God, and we are just, what a humbling thing to be a part of it. And let's just sing this together.
We fall down, we lay our crowns at the feet of Jesus. The great Jesus, and we cry, holy, holy, holy.
Together. We just have a few minutes left together on this, on the side of this hill. And as we sing this, I know there's this many people in a place like this. We'll all walk in with different stories. Some of you have been looking around all night, seeing people lifting their hands to God and singing. And you're saying, Chris, you have no idea how far I am from God. How could God ever hear my songs? And maybe you walk in here and you're carrying such a heavy load. You're carrying a lot of guilt and shame. And it's hard to lift your hands to God if you're carrying such a heavy load. So tonight, it's a beautiful time to just lay it down at the cross. What a wonderful cross. There is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. You have been set free. So whatever you walk on this field with tonight, we're going to have communion together, celebrate what Jesus has done. And as we sing these last words, when we get to the "My chains are gone," maybe the most beautiful sound on this field, those who know they've been set free, who know they've been redeemed by God, who know they're singing to a God tonight who is alive and well. They're not singing to a screen. We're singing to a God who's alive and well, and here's our songs. He didn't just create the earth and say, we're stuck with it, but made a way for us through his Son.
The earth shall soon dissolve. Sun forbear to shine, but God who called me will be forever mine. My chains are on, I've been set free. My God, my Savior.
a flood.
Night of worship. I love you, brother. Appreciate you. And we're going to go to the Lord's table now. And we do have.
Having a good time in the Lord.
Yes, I am.
Christ. It's a little thing. So, son, how are you? I'm in your face. I can't see you, but... Excuse me, young man.
Hi. What's up?
All part of the experience. Watch Dakota wipe out now, probably.
Okay, put it away.
I will soon.
Put it away now.
You're being recorded. This is all the little fishing, swimming holes. I mean, not fishing holes, but this place where we kind of come just down to either bathe, using the biodegradable soap, or just to play around.
Dude, our place is like sick. It's like it's tired.
Where? What?
Right there.
Alright, we'll check back later. We're going for a dip. Dippy!
Is it easier to get in that way?
Does it hurt my butt?
Yeah. I'm tired of that.
My butt hurts.
We're going down.
How do you get back
up? Yeah, this is a more description of Butt Slide Hill right here. I can't even imagine that. No, thank you. So, I feel like a little form here of people getting in the water. So, this guy's gonna try to walk on the mud, so I might as well just go ahead and videotape him because it's almost a guaranteed fall victim. Don't you fall. Oh, that kid just fell and missed him. So he's actually at least got shoes on, so he might have some traction. But like the place to be. Okay, is she gonna fall? Is she gonna fall? Is she gonna fall? Will she fall? We're gonna get her falling. Come on, girl. You gotta fall. He wiped out. Can't hold it still. Wow. Yeah, front flip off of it down there. Craziness. Zoomed in stuff. Alright. Ow, that's called pain. Ooh, there's a rope thing right there.
Yeah, but it's pretty shallow.
Yeah, that'd be crazy. Yeah, you don't want to do that. Go way back down here, downstream a little bit. Just go already, dude. Huh?
Ben, don't go belly down, okay?
Dude, I'll videotape
you,
dude.
I'm not stupid.
Are you sure about that?
There was already one stupid person that did it.
No.
Yeah, he's...
All right, man.
Okay. Ready?
All right, the butt slide hill into the river. Some dude.
I can't
I was wiping out. Is she going to wipe out? Where'd she go? Oh, no, she just knocked earth off. Will they fall? Who will wipe out first? And will they take each other down? Are they gonna make it? All right, that's boring. What? Cold man, zoom face. What's up? Where are you going? There's the butt slide dude right there, man.
The first part hurts.
It's just insane. You can tell they're young. No, thank you. So.
I would have done it, but I have white shorts.
How about you?
No.
Would you do it?
Nope. Dad would have done it.
No, thank you. This is the other watering hole here. You can tell it was a hot day, but everybody's cooling off, chilling out, doing the water gun thing. Enough people in the water. I always like getting the wipeouts on camera there, but I haven't really got any successful ones. So.
Hear me. Here's the whole point of this talk, but I want the world to get it. If you have to do something to get a gift, it's not a gift, it's a paycheck. If you have to work for something, it's a paycheck. Like this, sir, you have a job. What do you do for a living? He's a telephone, you're the one that called me. Anyway, all right. So, you're a telephone operator. How many hours do you work a week? About 40 hours. What company do you work for? Verizon. All right. Good company. They just hooked up an office. Anyway, all right. So you work 40 hours a week. How would you like? What's your name? Ron. You work 40 hours. Your boss comes to you and goes, here you go. Here's a gift. And hands you your paycheck. I don't know about you, Ron, but after I worked 40 hours, if somebody gave me a paycheck and said it was a gift, I would say something like this. What do you mean a gift? I earned this. I worked for this. I deserve this. Because you see, if you have to work for something, it's a paycheck. But that philosophy from a simple song, and I know you're like, why are we singing Santa Claus Coming to Town? Here's why. Because the song, even though there's nothing up on the, there's no screen here. But even though there's no words, there's nothing to read, we all know the words. Let me say this. As much as we know the words, I believe that philosophy of the world is in our hearts. That we feel like we have to be good enough to earn a gift. Take it to society. There was this guy named Paul. And when Paul was young, he was really short. And he was a big guy, so his big...
Just another view of some of the campsites and places where people are. Or as you can see, pretty much. Can't really cover it all. Pretty darn big. Right now there's speakers going on, so right there is where they do the baptism. It's actually right there. All right, boys. How you doing? Doing good.
So what do we got going on tonight?
We have...
Third day.
Who's the other dude?
Lincoln Brewster. Greg Laurie's a speaker. So we got 1,000 Foot Crutch, right? Then Lincoln Brewster, then Greg Laurie the speaker.
Lincoln Brewster, then 1,000 Foot Crutch.
Nope. Oh yeah, you're right. It's Lincoln Brewster first, and then 1,000 Foot Crutch. I don't know. I may be wrong. No big deal. Anyway, this is our shelter from the sun. It's pretty crazy. So we're gonna eat. It's supper time. Well, it's whatever it is. That was sweet, Coda. I caught it all on video too. So. All right. Bye.
Bye.
We went swimming. There was a dead animal in the water. Forrest liked it. He was taking a drink of water from his hands, and he saw the dead possum right next to him. It was gross.
Then he swallowed water.
Love me. This evening, if you have not noticed, we are out of doors, right? This is very obvious. Here's the thing, we need all evening long our outside voices on this stuff, okay? You guys, we're outside. It's gotta be loud, right? It's got to be loud. Me first. Here's what's happening. I'll sing a line and then you guys echo back whatever happens. You got that? Some of us are already on board, but here's that. Me first, and then you, it just has to be loud.
Right? And if you can't sing, just yell it out.
It's more yelling than singing. Pitch is absolutely unnecessary. We do not want to be used to it this loud. So it's all okay. All right, here we go. Track. There is no one like you.
I'm gonna
Everybody say hello to Mike. Say hi, Mike. Playing my favorite song ever written. That's it right there. All the songs, that's the one. Yeah. My favorite song, that's it. Run, Mario, run. All right. Okay, here's what we need to collectively go to 85. Everybody do this. Hands up in the air. This is my Jack. I'm about to give you 1985 here in the middle of Pennsylvania. That is Arena Rock, circa 85, brought to you by Rock Jovia. We're going to start innovating with the overhead flap. Woo! But we're looking around and spinning the night, thinking of more than just a decade. We're thinking of eternity. And what we'll be doing. Ha ha ha! Okay, here's what's any heroes here this evening.
Scream it out.
It is an addiction.
Scream it out. Where are you? Oh, guitar heroes.
Okay, here's what's happening. Listen. Well, I've got an upgrade here tonight. I've got the Wii remote. That's impressive. I am wireless now. I can roam about as far as Bluetooth will allow me to go, which is about 5 feet or so. I can get
really?
But yeah, that's it. It's rock and roll, Jack.
Yeah.
Okay, here's the deal. We need to meet B-Wack. Everybody, this is B-Wack, our drummer. So, okay, so B-Wack, here's what's happened.
Is he building something back there?
Yeah, he's working right now. Here's what's happened. His head works in ways the rest of us cannot comprehend, and here's what he's done. He's taken your common everyday Guitar Hero controller, some might say a toy, Jack, and he's turned it into none other than a professional musical instrument. That's what's happening.
Pro instrument.
This is all pro.
Yeah.
This is all. Hey, we haven't met Mark yet. Mark, everybody say hi to Mark. It dawns on me we should do something before we get too far into this thing. You guys heard of the Twitter? You got the Twitter? Three people here on Twitter. That's amazing.
Maybe five. I counted five.
Hey, can we get some likes on the beautiful people here at Creation this year? We need to document something. I need you to take a picture of the fine people, Mark, if you could, to post on the Twitter. This needs to be documented for the World Wide Web. Look pretty. Best faces of them. If you can't see the camera, it can't see you.
I have a problem.
You get them? Oh, what's the deal?
I don't have cellular service.
Oh yeah, we're out in the middle of nowhere. You can't post on Twitter.
You can't tweet.
Hey, they've got the fantastic Wi-Fi here this year. You guys using the Wi-Fi that Creation has had to offer? That's beautiful. You have the Wi-Fi, Mark?
I'll have to do that later.
Okay. All right. I want to see these beautiful people on Twitter. Okay, here's what we need. This is the rock and roll I'm sending out. This is your blue button. This is the rock button. And then you've got your green button here with the one chord. You got your five chord and your four chord.
This seems very complex.
This is music theory, Jack. Just stay with me. That's your six chord. This is really hard.
Yeah.
It's basically, I see where you're going. We've robbed all musicality from what we've done, and now I'm just pushing buttons. I like it, though. It makes me happy inside. Okay, the most important button is this one right here, though. Everybody pay attention. This is compliments of the B-Wack. Mark, do you know what that is?
Yes.
Can you show me how Mario gets the coin? I'd love to know.
Yeah!
Is athletic. Oh, yeah. Athletic bunch. That's impressive. Okay, here's what we need. We need some more group singing. It worked out so well earlier. We'll try again. So here's how it worked, Jack. I'll sing a line, and then you guys just echo right. Oh, it dawns on me. We have an interpreter here. I'm curious for the hearing impaired. How did this come off? What is this?
What's the sign for
this? Sing the sign
coin.
For the coin.
It's like a
this.
Push.
It's this?
It's like guns.
You like...
That is solid work. Solid. Okay. Me first, and then you quite exuberantly. I'm so glad we're here with you people this evening. This is good. Yeah. Have y'all had a great time here or what? Has it been amazing or what? I wish they did it more than once a year. That's all I'm saying. Okay, well, we're all from Texas. If you've been with us before here at Creation, and we normally call back home in our part of the world, a hoedown. We are out of doors with our best friends in the whole world. And we gotta have a little foot stomping and hand clapping and loud singing. This little song, I Saw the Light by Hank Williams singing. Let's have a good singing.
Are you singing? message, I got a song. Everybody help me sing along. I got a message, I got a song. Everybody help me sing along. Sing. I got a song, everybody help me sing along. Hey, I got a message, I got a song, everybody help me sing along.
Leave them up there just for a second. Raise your hand if you have seen Third Day in concert before. 15. I don't, 15 times you've seen us? I don't know whether to hug you or call security on you. One of them. Oh, yeah, security. Okay, well, I'm in trouble now. Raise your hand if this is the first time you've ever seen Third Day. We gotta get up here more often now. Is everybody on the hill doing all right? I see you. This is for all the old school fans out there. I am a thief. I am a murderer. Walking up this lonely hill. What have I done? I don't remember. No one knows just how I feel. And I know that my time is coming soon. It's been so long, oh, such a long time since I've lived in peace and rest. Now I am here at my destination. Now these things work. About Third Day, we have we've been a band for it's crazy, for over 17 years now.
Wow.
Yeah, I remember when our first record came out back in, well, independently it came out in 95, and then it got picked up by a major label and put out in 96. And around that time, the legendary Christian rock band Petra was celebrating, they were celebrating 20 years of being a band together around the time we put out our first album. And I remember praying to the Lord when I found out about that 20 years and our first record comes out. I remember praying and saying, Lord Jesus, please do not let us be together for 20 years. I don't even want to be doing this that long. But trying to find my way, trying to find the faith that's gone. I know that you are holding all the answers. I'm tired of losing hope and dreaming of chances. All the roads that never change to be the ones that bring me home. Come on. Yeah. did not receive him. But as many as receive him, to them he gives the right to become the children of God, even those who believe in his name, who were born not of blood and the flesh, but by the Spirit of God. The Word of God also tells us that Jesus spoke to his disciples and he said this. He said, "You are the light of the world. You are a city that is set on a hill that cannot be hidden." He tells us that no one should light a lamp and then put it under a bushel or to hide it, but rather to let your light shine so that the entire world may see, that they may see your good works, and that they may give glory to the Father who is in heaven. And as we stand here tonight, holding these candles, this arena, with all the dazzling, wonderful lights that our guys bring and everything, this arena never looks more beautiful than when you look out tonight and you see these candles. And you say, "Lord, this is an illustration of what it's all about." Because, you know, Jesus is the light of the world. And Jesus said, "If you follow me and you're my disciple, you are the light of the world." And he said that we as believers, all those who have trusted in him, the church of the living God, that we are a city set on a hill that cannot be hidden. Well, here we are on a hill, but there's a world out there that needs this light. A dark world in so many ways that needs the light of the gospel. If you believe in Jesus as the light of the world in your heart, just lift that candle a little higher right now. And as we lift it, we say, "Lord Jesus, you are the light of the world." And as on the day of Pentecost, when your Holy Spirit was poured out and there were tongues of fire, like you pulled back a veil so that people could see the light that was within them, that somehow we could get a glimpse of the power and the light that crushes darkness. Lord Jesus, make us a city set on a hill. Make us a light in such a way that we will walk into our communities, into our world, into a world that is filled with so many, many needs, that we will walk in as the light, knowing that you fill us with your light. Crush any darkness that's in us and only allow your Spirit to shine as we go forth as your people, the light of the world. Jesus, you're the light. Fill us with your Spirit and let your light shine. Would you turn and kind of look around if you can at what's happening behind you? Don't set your neighbor's hair on fire, but just kind of look around. Get a little picture of it, what you can see. And you know what? When you walk into your high school, when you walk into your workplace, I pray that you'll remember, first of all, you're not alone. Jesus is with you. He'll never leave you. He'll never forsake you. Some of you are going back to homes that are difficult situations. You're not alone. But not only are you not alone with Christ with you, but you have brothers and sisters who are in this together. We're actually going to be in heaven together for eternity. And there is no darkness in heaven. And we will be with the light of the world. Praise you, Lord. Could we sing? Praise God. You want me to hold your candle? Or you can? You maybe you're able to do that, but I haven't known many people that can. You love Mac on Third Day.
Oh God, you are.
God, you are my God.
Oh, God, you are my God.
I will praise you.
And I will ever praise you.
I will seek you in the morning. God's people said?
Amen.
Wow. Let's give, you know, you can't give the Lord a hand. You got your hands full of candles, but here's the Lord. Now I'm going to ask you to be careful and extinguish these. That you can extinguish them now. And please take them with you. You can take them as a remembrance, or you can put them in a receptacle, but don't leave them here in the arena. Third day, Mac, thank you again. We love you. Wow, fantastic. Joining with us up here on the stage are many of our supervisors who are serving you and staff, and so we've just praised God for them and family too. Okay, Mark?
Shaking. Dakota's making the popcorn. Forrest's doing the peanut butter and jelly.
Dad's videotaping.
Keep going.
Yeah, what do I do with the jelly spoon?
Lick it off.
All of it?
Okay, Dakota, stop a second. Okay, it's done. Get it off.
Yum.
Yummy.
Okay. Turn off the burner.
How do I do that? There you go.
Coolio. Okay, first hold the flashlight, please.
Put it on the knob.
Thanks.
What? Oh, just kidding.
Creation. 09, Saturday. Jam packed. This is the tarp run.
I'm running!
You better not!
Sarah Weber.
Alright. Empty field. It's 5:22. Empty field. Once they announce it,
I'm tired.
It'll take, what, 1 minute?
It'll take 1 minute for the whole entire field to get full.
The tarp run. The infamous creation tarp run. All right, we'll check with you later.
Oh, good. Don't fall on your rope. Run it.
It needs to be like 5 minutes to be done.
We're gonna have to knock all these tarps off the field there too before we even do anything.
Tarp run. 09, Saturday, take two.
In all the years I've been here, I've never seen them call them back.
I've seen them call them back like 3 times.
Yeah, never. Just like in the recent years they started doing this or what?
Dad?
Go, girls, put it down.
Right there. Oh, what's happening?
That's a prior position right there.
So Dakota, did you enjoy the infamous tarp run? Now should be called a tarp what?
Walk.
A tarp what?
Tarp walk.
A tarp what?
Walk!
Okay. It's now called a tarp walk because they called people back and made us wait 30 minutes before we were allowed to go take our tarps back out. We had a great location, but they really did. They made everyone pull their tarps up, and we had to go back to the starting line again. And instead of it being 5:30 this morning, the tarp walk was at 6 this morning. Everyone was funny and ticked off. But anyway, It's a beautiful morning. And we're heading back to the tent. So, did probably pop. Probably watch there. I was gonna try to catch the sunrise over here, but it's right there behind those trees.